Hey there guys and gals, and welcome back to the D4A channel. Now, after I published my bicarb converted 4AG engine rebuild video, I got a lot of questions asking a lot of different things. You know, stuff like from which bike are the carbs from, what kind of cams do you have, and so on and so forth. So today I decided to make a quick little video where I'm going to cover all of the details and specs of the engine and hopefully answer a lot of those questions. So first thing, of course, is the most obvious thing, and it's the bike carbs themselves. So the bike carbs are actually from a Honda CBR 600, which is a 600cc motorcycle, of course. They are from a 1999 FXFY model, I believe, which is also called the F4 generation. Now, my motorcycle knowledge is definitely second to my car knowledge, so double check that. Now, some people may think that the carbs from a 600cc motorcycle engine are actually too small for a car engine. And you will see that a lot of people with bike carb converted engines use carbs from 1000cc motorcycle engines, most often the Yamaha R1. Now, that may be the case if you have a large engine, something like 2 liters or even bigger, or if you have a heavily modified engine. In the case of my 4AG, which is 1.6 liters, and isn't too heavily modified, though these carbs are actually going to flow better and are going to make better power throughout the entire rev range, which means that I'm not going to have a horribly pathetic low end, you know, of my power curve and my torque curve. Now, another nice thing about these carbs is that they already come with a 3-wire OEM throttle position sensor. Now, this is good because I need this to have 3D fully customizable ignition maps with my Notice Pro ignition ECU. So what I also recommend is, if you decide to do a bicarb conversion, definitely get bicarbs that already have a throttle position sensor, because that's going to make your life a lot easier later on. Another thing a lot of people ask about is the jetting of the carbs. And the answer is yes, the carbs will need to be jetted. Now, I got my kit, including the carbs, from Dan ST Engineering, and if you buy it from there, the carbs come pre-jetted. But that's, you know, just so you can fire the car up and move it around. To get the most out of the setup, the carbs will probably need more jetting. To address that, I did get a full jet kit from a company called Six Sigma Racing, and it's a very comprehensive kit that includes pretty much everything you're going to need. And in the description of the video, you can find a link to that product itself, along with the links, you know, to everything else that you can see on this engine. To figure out jetting, I'm going to be using my AEM X Series wideband gauge, which is going to tell me, you know, whether I'm running lean or rich at all the different throttle positions, and based on that, I'm going to be replacing the jets one by one until I get, you know, a perfect setup. So next up is this sexy part right here, which are the velocity stacks. Now, these are also from Dan ST Engineering, and there's actually a little story behind them. When I first got the carbs, they came with the original little velocity stacks, trumpets, whatever you want to call them. Now, these are very fragile, so they got bent during shipping. So I got in touch with Dan ST Engineering. I told them, you know, the trumpets are damaged, and they were really awesome, and they just told me, you know, send them back, we're going to fix them. So what they did is they welded these much bigger, you know, much more sexy velocity stacks on those stock little trumpets, and then I powder coated them into this lovely sky blue color. Now, this backplate also came from Dan ST Engineering, and you needed to be able to attach the Piper Cross filter to the carbs. Originally, it came unpainted, but I had it powder coated in black to match the look of the rest of the engine. Moving on to the underside of the intake manifold for the carbs, you can see some hose tails. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 smaller hose tails and 2 bigger ones. Now, the smaller ones I originally intended to use to connect actually to a vacuum balancing bar to balance the signal to my map sensor. Now, since I have moved on to the Notice Pro Ignition, I won't be using a map sensor, I'll be going with the throttle position sensor. The other two big hose tails are actually used for the brake booster, and you need them because without, you know, vacuum provided to the brake booster, your brake pedal would be rock hard and driving the car would not be nice at all. So the cams are actually 2 exhaust camshafts from the CAD/CAM set number 7105136. This means that they have 244 degrees of duration at 0.1 millimeters, and they have 8 millimeters left. Now, this is nothing aggressive, they're actually pretty mild cams, but they should give a nice little bump in performance. I do plan to go with more aggressive cams later on, with more lift and more duration, if I don't go turbo or something, you know, completely different before that. So the cylinder head itself has been resurfaced, and the valves and valve seats have been machined. Also, I have ported and polished the head myself, and the stock valve springs have been replaced with some stiffer HKS valve springs. So the head gasket is actually a stock OEM Toyota head gasket, and just like all the other gaskets on this engine, I know a stock head gasket thickness is going to cost me some compression and performance, but I decided to use it, you know, in order to minimize potential damage to the engine internals, just in case I mess something up, because the stock head gasket thickness keeps this engine non-interference. The pistons inside the engine block are actually 0.5 millimeter oversized, slightly domed pistons from the Toyota 4AG small port. I decided to use these because they keep the engine non-interference, but they give a small bump in compression because the compression inside the small port is 10.3 compared to the 9.4 to 1 compression inside the 4AG big port. Now the cylinder block, as you can see, has been restored, and I have painted it with some POR 15 engine enamel paint. When it comes to the exhaust manifold, right now the solution is going to be this horrible cast iron piece of ugliness, which is the stock exhaust manifold. But the plan is to, as soon as the car is started and, you know, mobile, to make a custom, you know, much nicer, better performing exhaust manifold. The timing belt cover, as you can see, looks almost new. I of course didn't buy a new timing belt cover. I don't think they even exist new anymore. What I did is I lightly sanded, you know, the original timing belt cover, and then painted it with the same kind of paint I used to restore my engine bay and my wheel wells, and that's this stone chip protection paint. It's a really nice product that adheres to any surface really well. Unfortunately, I think it's only available in Europe. I have yet to install it, but the flywheel that's going on this engine is actually a 20 valve blacktop 4AG flywheel that is a great compromise between drivability and rev happiness, because it's just a bit lighter than the stock 4AG 16 valve big port flywheel. The clutch is just a OEM replacement unit from Aisin. So I guess that's pretty much when it comes to all the details I wanted to present about this engine. If you still have any more questions, please feel free to, you know, ask in the comment section, and I'll definitely be happy to answer any sort of questions you might have. Also, you already know about the MRP cam belt stabilizer and the Technotoy tuning part, so I won't be mentioning that again in this video. Another thing I want to say is that my channel has recently hit 20,000 subscribers. Now, this is something I honestly never expected that would be reality, and what I want to say is definitely a huge, huge thank you right from the heart to all of my subscribers and to everyone who has been watching and supporting this channel, because I honestly appreciate that very, very much. So I guess that's pretty much it for today. As always, don't forget to share, like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll be seeing you soon on the D4A channel.